Thank you, Toastmaster Maria. Well, good evening, Toastmaster Aditya. I hope you are nervous and excited for your first P1 speech. The objective of this speech is of your P1, the icebreaker speech, is to introduce yourself to the club and make yourself well known. I will be evaluating your speech on the following criteria of them being content, which includes your speech, and the delivery of your speech. So that includes the cadence, the intonations, the gestures, and the overall flow of the speech and how it progresses. So with that, I best of luck, and I hope you're a great speech. So thank you, Toastmaster Maria. Back to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Moaz. Now let's welcome Toastmaster Aditya to deliver his icebreaker, Diary of a Movie Buff. Toastmaster Aditya, it's all yours.
Thank you, Toastmaster Maria. Gajni, a special case of short-term memory loss. That was the first chapter of my life. Good evening, everyone. This is Toastmaster Aditya, and today I'm here with my P1 speech. As I told you, the first chapter of my life is pretty much related to the character Sanjay Singhania from the movie Gajni, a man who is king of his own life. I'm quite related to that character because I don't remember any part of that life. All I remember are bits of memories and some stories that I hear from my relatives and my parents, just like he had his tattoos. Oh, and all that I could conclude from those stories and memories is that I was a very notorious brat. Though I was named after a god, which I won't reveal, by the way. I was named after a god because my parents thought that why not give my son a name which is related to God so that character would reflect on me. But that was not the case. Things turned out differently. One day, I was playing cricket with my dad. He was bowling and I was batting. He had this thing he would always try to do is he would spin the ball or he would give a bouncer so that I couldn't even touch the ball. But this time, things went out of control. I got very frustrated and very angry at him just because I couldn't touch a single ball. In that heat of the situation, I don't know how, but by mistake, I gave some really decent bad words to my father that no one would even dare to do. I did that. Now, let me tell you one thing, why I remember this memory, why I have this memory. It's because of the special counseling session which was given by my dad. He was the host of this counseling session just after this incident happened. This counseling session lasted for about 10 to 20 minutes. And those 20 minutes were the minutes that I would never forget, never ever forget. I won't go into the details. You can understand what I went through. But that was me. But then slowly things changed. I joined a new school, a very strict missionary school. And here I played the character of Bajrangi from the movie Bajrangi Bhaijaan. Yes, a very sweet, innocent kid who would never do a thing to hurt anyone. A person who is an overthinker. Yes, that was me. Apart from that, I was also an introvert kid. I was so introvert that once I made a record of not talking to girls of my school for one whole year, though it was a co-ed school. That was me. So whenever people ask me about this event, I flex about it and use the term Sakt Londa, which you all must be very familiar with. But the reality is, you know, I was an introvert. But then again, things again changed when I changed my school. Now, I went into a boarding school in New Delhi for 2 years. Now, those 2 years were the greatest turning point in my life. Those were the years which were the most amazing ones in my life. That was the place where I played the role of Walter White from the series Breaking Bad. And those of you who don't know what Breaking Bad is about, it is about a person named Walter White who is very sweet and innocent, but situation make him a drug dealer and a very dangerous man. Spoilers alert, I should have said. So now that was me. I changed a lot. I started talking to people I started making friends, whole bunch of new friends. I started taking part in events in sports, co-curricular events. I started taking a lot of part in sports, which helped me to explore myself a lot. But the thing is, you don't change suddenly. When I joined the school, there was still a little part of Bajrangi inside me. Now that Bajrangi prevented me once again to prevented me from speaking to my crush for one whole year. Yeah, it did that again. But slowly and steadily, I suppressed that Bajrangi and I finally got the confidence to go out and speak in front of her. But the thing is, by the time I got that confidence, she left the school. She was a senior, and the day at which I got that confidence was my farewell day. And that too, it was the last moment. I couldn't even talk to her. But I was happy. It was sad, but I was happy that I was not the same introvert kid I used to be. Apart from all these, I also learned some of the most important and the most thrilling things in my life, like this thing changed the whole perspective of me seeing things. Like, for example, I learned that you don't give bad words to the people you don't know. You only use bad words for the people you very well know, for the people you stay with, for the people you share your room with, right? You can't simply go and say some bad word to a stranger, especially in places like Delhi, because you don't know. The very next moment, there'll be a Scorpio full of people having holding bats and different hockey sticks and different rackets and different sporting equipments that you might not have even played. Yeah, that happens in that stuff happens in Delhi. But that was me. Still, something, some final touch was needed. Something was needed because I was not really good at anything. Now, that final touch I got when I was in Kota preparing for my JEE. That was the time where I played the role of Sultan Ali Khan from the movie Sultan. That was the time where I realized what my mistakes were, where I was wrong, and how to improve myself. That was the place where I changed myself, where I transformed myself to who I am right now. I'm not a perfect person. No, I'm not. I'm not good at anything. But the thing is, I'm better than how I used to be. And I'm thankful for that. Now the question arises, what's next? The thing is, even I don't know. That's a suspense story, still a work under progress. So stay tuned. Till then, thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Aditya. It was a wonderful speech. We now all know how awesome you truly are.